in Asia, they actually, Nike releases like PH versions for, I don't know exactly what that stands for, but it stands for 4 foot. But,
thank you everybody for clicking on that video. Gotta tell you about our sponsor, Dashlane. Dashlane is the mobile and desktop app that's gonna help you do everything online, whether you're trying to log in instantly, fly through forms, or breeze through checkouts so you don't miss any exclusive drops. Definitely check out Dashlane. There's a link down below that can give you a discount as well, but more on that later. Enjoy the rest of this video.
What's going on, everybody? The NBA season has started, and guess what? That means there is a brand new batch of performance basketball shoes that have entered the market.
In this video, we are going to be reviewing all of the top 2019 basketball shoes. Let's go. And if you're excited to watch the sneaker review, make sure you hit that like button.
Leading off the new crop of shoes for the 2019-2020 NBA season, Andrew. Yeah. I think we have to talk about a shoe that's not even out right now.
Ooh, the Kyrie Sixes.
It looks like a Kyrie 5 mixed with a Yeezy 2.
I love these. They're coming out with so many different colorways.
They're releasing 11. Dude, the Tokyo ones. Andrew, what you have in your hand, by the way, is an LA colorway.
This is the LA colorway. I don't know if they kind of took the UCLA color, because this is kind of that Bruin blue. But Kyrie's, obviously the traction is sick. And from most reviews, they say the traction is amazing. And if you guys know, of course, Kyrie's are known for having traction up on the corners of the shoe.
Because if you guys have ever seen the way Kyrie dribbles, it is incredibly unique, because his foot will just hit the ground at the weirdest angles. So he needs that traction to run up the side of the shoe.
Here's what I like. I'm a big fan of the return of the midfoot strap. You know, I love the midfoot strap and the Zoom Turbo here. They have injected Phylon. So this is like a new Phylon. It's better than the old Phylon.
But it depends a lot on the implementation of Phylon.
Right.
Phylon, you guys, being a lot of people are like, oh, is it just regular Phylon in the heel? It's like, depending on how, like what quality they had the Phylon at, it could feel almost as good as a cushioning. Kyrie does not wear this exact version of the shoe.
No,
he's got probably full length Zoom, full length carbon fiber shape plate.
It's a well-known fact that NBA players, they're not wearing the exact same shoe that you can buy at like Foot Locker. They're actually wearing a reinforced enhanced version of their own shoe. Honestly, I think it just helps them play better.
The exterior details on the shoe are insane. For a shoe that's $130, Andrew, look at the way everything rises up on the heel. We're talking about a vertical gradient. Dude, this strap has so much design work into it.
I think if you just look at the details of the shoe, it's crazy. For $130, and you get good cushioning.
Oh my gosh, man. David, I am definitely playing. They feel good out of the box.
Yo, you look like Kyrie right now.
I will have these and I will hoop in them, and I'm excited to try.
Andrew, we're going from the Kyrie, which has kind of always been viewed as a budget model,
yeah,
all the way up to the most expensive line that Nike carries, the $200 LeBron line.
Yeah.
This is the LeBron 17 right now, guys.
Hey, I can tell you this, just feeling it, they have this knitposite, which is essentially a very ultra strong blend between battle knit and fly knit. All right, so you have a Air Max C, which this is the same kind of Air Max that they have in the Air Max 270s, where it's just shaped in a C and it ends like about, well, it ends right here, I guess. So it ends right here and then has a super thick Zoom unit.
Lately, in the LeBrons, the Zoom units have been articulated.
Yes, articulated meaning that they're separated.
Or segmented. And the reason is, it's because LeBron wants to flex in the forefoot. And sometimes when you have just a whole big Zoom unit slab, it doesn't flex as well. I have a wide midfoot and forefoot. The weird thing is, this shoe, it looks like it's really bulky and beefy, but I would say the forefoot is average and the midfoot is like slightly even more narrow because it's caged in.
Do you see how thin it gets right around the midfoot? Even that's a problem for me, somebody with narrow feet, because I actually have flat feet. So my arch is actually bulging out of here when I tried these on. So basically, this is not gonna be the shoe for me for a number of reasons, but I think this is a sick looking shoe.
I really didn't like that black and gray one. But then that gray and orange one, the gray and orange colorway.
There's like a silver color. I don't even know all the colors, but I just see some of them. And I'm like, these are sick. But David, Disappointing for a number of reasons.
A lot of people were saying they could imagine for certain players this being the best shoe just because it has a ton of impact protection. It's pretty comfortable due to the knit. But I just think the traction pattern too, it's gonna be good for like big hard stops, but not a lot of little intricate movements. To me, the reason that I don't like the fact that they made the midfoot really tight is because it's like, what people that require this tier of traction have a narrow midfoot?
David, I feel like you feel a little done wrong by the LeBron line with this one.
You're
like a little offended.
Yeah.
Because you're like, hey man, LeBron line, you guys were always for wide footers. And then what are you giving me right here? What is this thin, like, essentially it's like wearing like a, this shoe has like a corset on the middle of the midfoot. And guess what? For flat footers, it's not good either. So guess what? I can't wear these, but it's a beautiful shoe. I hope the people who buy them enjoy them because you spent a lot of money on them.
Yo, Andrew, you could not resist yourself when we got to the New Balance Omnis, the Kawhi Leonard. Andrew, considering New Balance had not come out with a signature performance shoe for basketball, I believe in 10 years, this was an incredible first offer.
Yo, it's crazy that a New Balance shoe was this hype.
I gotta say that this is, I don't know, this shoe looks amazing.
This shoe looks like, all right, so the traction looks incredible, has a New Balance sign. What I heard was that since there are so many little small lines here, it gives good traction, but it does pick up dust pretty quickly.
You gotta wipe it.
Look at that.
Oh,
look at how many teeth there are.
Yo, Andrew, I can just tell by this rubber compound too. Andrew, whatever type of rubber compound this is crazy.
Hey, that's like that Firestone rubber.
Yeah.
So what I love is this midfoot strap. It kind of reminds me of the Harden 3s, one of my favorite shoes of all time. I don't really know how much this is gonna do because it's stretchy, but it's just kind of like a cool thing to have this band on it. I will say they have Fuel Cell in the midsole, which is the New Balance type of cushioning, which is considered not the most responsive, but it's really soft and it's comfortable.
Did you know that this is the only basketball shoe this year in America that they're gonna release in different widths?
That's cool.
Asians actually have really wide forefoots. In Asia, they actually, Nike releases like PH versions for, I don't know exactly what that stands for, but it stands for forefoot.
What I do see for me is that I have a narrow foot, and actually I would say already on the regular pair, the forefoot is a little bit wide, and I heard that the lockdown is not 10 out of 10. So your foot might move a tiny bit, which is not ideal for people who really want to make sharp cuts.
I think that this is an incredible first shoe for New Balance. I hope they just keep it up, keep building on it. I think this is a great foundational point for them.
With this shoe, David, and combined with Kawhi's superstar play, do you think that New Balance can really make a splash in the basketball sneaker market?
For sure. It's a start.
These are the Robot Air Jordans right here.
Next up, we've got the Giannis Antetokounmpo, the Zoom Freak 1.
This is coming in at $120 price point, so very budget, very good pricing for a lot of people. It's a low cut shoe. I love the swoosh here. This is the Roses Edition colorway. There's got a lot of great meaning, a tribute to Greece and a tribute to his father. Man, I actually love the way the shoe looks. I think it's an amazing looking shoe.
I do think the upper of the shoe looks a little cheap, just material wise.
It feels a little cheap.
But the design is sick. I know not everybody liked this like reverse swoosh, but then people liked it on the Travis Scott one. It's really low cut. It's got double stack zoom in the heel and no cushioning in the front.
I would say the cushioning is not amazing in these shoes, but you do feel it.
There's a ton of court feel.
Yeah, there's a ton of court feel. It's super low. I love the silhouette personally. I like how you have kind of the straps that come out here, so that's gonna lock your foot in place. It looks like it has pretty good traction. Maybe this rose doesn't give quite the best traction, but definitely this multi-directional herringbone traction right here is good.
Overall, I thought this was a very strong entry into the market. It reminds me a lot of the Kyrie one.
Yeah.
When the Kyrie one entered the market.
You know what I like? I really like the lockdown. I love shoes with really good heel counters and heel padding because when you tie them up, it just pushes your heel into the back of your foot. All right, everybody, I gotta tell you about Dashlane, because if you're someone like me who's constantly traveling, always shopping online, or just living life, this could be the life hack that you actually need. If you're on the move, you can use Dashlane to sync all your credit cards, travel documents, and passport information between devices and book tickets easily by autofilling everything from your address to your frequent flyer miles. I mean, listen, the built-in VPN lets you access the content you want wherever you want, you know, whether you're international or on random Wi-Fi. So when you're shopping, it can fill out addresses and payment details in just one click. And the autofill allows you to never miss another time-sensitive drop again. Listen, guys, I cannot stress to you how much this app can change your online life. It can make it way more efficient, flexible, and secure. You know, I just feel better using it. Plus, your info is encrypted and stored safely so that even Dashlane doesn't have access to it. So if you're interested in a 30-day free trial, go to dashlane.com/phonebros, or for 10% off of Dashlane Premium, type in the code FUNGBROS. That's Phone Bros. Guys, remember, anywhere you want to go, anything you want to buy, Dashlane is there to help you get it done safely and secure. All right, check out the rest of that sneaker review.
Next up, we've got the Harden 4. Andrew,
wow,
you
got David,
so much to say.
I got a lot to say today. I got time for this.
Well, Andrew, just tell them how you feel, because tell them how you feel, because you had 5 pairs of the Harden 3s.
Five pairs.
It was probably, you could put it up there with your favorite shoes of all time.
I thought I met my soulmate with the Harden 3s, man. I don't feel anything close to the same with these, man. Something about them, they're super flat.
Some of the reviews have come in mixed. Some people do love these.
Some people love them. I'm sure some people love them, but I'm not even sure if James Harden loves them. He's shooting 30% from the three and 40% from the field.
Bruh.
I'm not a fan of these. I don't feel quick in them. I don't like the cushioning. They're super wide and flat and just plants my feet.
They replace the Boost.
They replaced the full-length Boost with full-length Light Strike. Light Strike is this new material Adidas is pushing. They also have them on the next level. Those are the slip-on with prime knit that Trae Young is wearing.
It's designed to feel like a higher-end bounce.
It's supposed to give you, you know, a really good court feel, some responsiveness. So guys, on the bottom, it kind of is giving you the shape of the feet you wear. So this and the Don Issue 1s, the Donovan Mitchells, they have a similar pattern where it's not really the feet you wear, the old Adidas thing where they would have pods like on your pressure points of your feet. Anyways, guys, Harden 4s, personally not a huge fan, but you guys just got to try them on yourself. Harden is still averaging 36 points a game in these, so I guess he can't be that wrong.
Next up, after the Harden 4, we've got the Curry 7.
Wow. Whoa. I'm actually really excited to talk about these and put these on.
I got to say this. I don't really think this shoe looks great from a lifestyle standpoint, but just having this in hand, I've got to say that this feels like this could be a performance monster.
Man, and yo, shout out to Curry. His hand got broken. The Warriors are all in disarray, but this shoe is not in disarray. So they have a combination of Hover and Micro G. Micro G, traditionally considered one of the best cushionings. I don't know why Under Armour doesn't use it more and more traditionally, because the cushioning between the Hover and the Micro G, it doesn't work that well in this shoe. I wouldn't say the cushioning is amazing, but Curry's cushionings were never amazing.
Remember, Andrew, when the Curry 2 back 5 years ago?
Next up, coming up from Under Armour, the Curry 2s.
Was the number one selling basketball shoe entire year.
Yeah.
They really, really dropped the ball since then.
A few times they have, yeah. I don't know what was going on at Under Armour, but this is probably the first shoe in a while that I actually really like the look of. I like this, it looks sleek. This kind of like straight line design here is kind of cool. This back is very solid because it has this kind of orange plating around it. I'll say this little like cleft in the back is kind of funny, like this little butt crack here. But it really helps you roll from the heel to the toe. So the heel to toe transition is really nice.
I will say this traction pattern looks so aggressive. It looks like you just put a bunch of spikes sticking out of a flat pattern. This, oh my goodness.
David, this looks like, you know what a freaking Machu Picchu looks like? You know, the little structures that they have. I like the look of these. These kind of look like a really cool snowmobile. It really looks unique to me. Overall, I really want to wear these, and I'm excited to play in these because I just heard a lot of good things.
I think this shoe is going to really sell well.
Yeah.
Next up, after the Curry 7, we've got the Don Issue 1.
Woo!
AKA the Donovan Mitchell, the first Donovan Mitchell signature shoe to enter the market. Andrew, I actually played in these. I had the red and the blue version.
Yeah.
I do think they fit, like a lot of Adidas shoes fit, a half size big. Okay. So I suggest if your Nike size is a 10, you get a 9.5 in Adidas.
This is all bounce cushioning right here. For me, when I first put them on, it was a red flag because they feel like the Harden 4s. Kind of long, flat, again, exaggerated outriggers on the side, so it's very stable.
You know, for me, I actually really do enjoy this shoe. It's like a little bit weird for me because I just think it's a low cut shoe that rides a little high off the ground, because the footbed sits kind of high and then the shoe is cut really low. But other than that, I think this is an incredible performer for $100. I've never personally had a shoe that ever felt like this before. It almost reminds me of the Jet Flights from back in the day.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
I don't feel fast in these. Like this and the Hardens. This is the problem. To me, this is like a slightly firmer version of the Hardens.
I think this is an amazing half-court shoe. If you play a lot of half-court basketball, you should look into this because obviously you're gonna be doing a lot less running, making heel-to-toe transition in a way not as important. I think this was an amazing first shoe for Donovan Mitchell.
No, it's cool.
For $100,
hey, man.
If you gave me this shoe and you made me play in it, I'm not mad at all. Next up, we've got a shoe from last season.
Yeah.
But it's the number one, apparently was the number one selling basketball shoe of the 2018-2019 season.
I still don't believe it.
The Russell Westbrook Why Not 02.
Wow. This goes down as one of the most interesting looking shoes. It looks like an art piece, like Basquiat designed these because they have different textures, they have different shapes. It looks crazy.
I will say this. I was so looking forward to the shoe, but the only thing was, midfoot was crunching me.
From what I felt when I had these on, you feel quick in them. Yeah! Like it kind of propels you forward. This is one of those shoes that has really good heel to toe transition. You know, I think as far as sprinting down the court to dunk on somebody, I think this is a shoe.
Yo, this traction pattern is fascinating too.
Yeah.
Little circles.
I heard
almost looks like a Kuji logo.
The traction pattern is really nice. And I like how it kind of looks like little suction cups almost. Yeah.
For a very particular type of player, I think that this shoe is gonna be like a 9 out of 10, or maybe even a 10 out of 10.
Right.
Andrew, we have probably got one of the most hype releases for 2019-2020 in our hands right
and
now.
And currently one of the shoes that you are wearing for basketball yourself.
Correct. We've got the Jordan 34.
Wow, this shoe looks sick. And there's not a lot of shoes out there that you can see through. I like the traction pattern. I heard that the traction is pretty much like a 9 out of 10, 8 out of 10. You know what struck me about these shoes is that they're really light.
They
are. I would say it's a pretty light shoe.
I think the Jordan brand is back and committed to being the highest performance basketball brand, whether that's sneakers, apparel, accessories, in the whole game.
I'm interested because it's very lightweight. This material is very soft and I don't know how they're gonna enhance Zion's pair, but I don't know, he might rip through this or something.
So Andrew, I'm hooping in the Jordan 34 right now, as well as a lot of older shoes.
Mm-hmm.
What else are you playing in?
All right guys, I am wearing the Kobe 80 NXT Fast Fits, and I'm also wearing the KD 12.
I think the biggest tip that I would give people is to either double up on thick socks or go down half a size.
Yeah.
And the shoe that feels too tight on your feet, it's okay while you're playing.
Yeah.
You don't necessarily want a shoe that feels amazingly comfortable off the court and on the court.
Basically, you just don't want things to be rubbing at the wrong angle.
But remember guys, there are so many different factors to why you like a shoe, and everybody's gonna be different because like we said, there's your heel, your midfoot, your forefoot, your instep, your arch, and even sort of like the way your foot hits the ground. And two people can wear the same shoe and then have different opinions on the traction. It's because their foot strike is different. I do think that generally though, if people say this shoe is great for wide footers, then if you're a wide footer, you owe it to yourself to go try that on.
Absolutely. All right, so the shoes that we don't have with us right now are the Dame 6, the PG3s, and the Puma Clyde Hardwoods, which I'm very excited about because one of the first basketball shoes in a while that has real leather, so I'm excited.
Andrew, what do you want to tell people about performance kicks? Because why are we so nerdy about this? Obviously, we're not pro players. We're not even dropping 30 in rec leagues, but we're just so into it.
I think it's just kind of fun. It's a culture that we're into, and it's always fun to ask people. Like, every time I see somebody with the Adapt BBs, I'm always asking them, yo, how are those shoes? Because I've actually never really had a chance to try those. Also, now, with all these basketball trainers out, you can kind of learn to train and play like certain players to an extent. So I'm in the Why Nots. I can attack the hoop, you know, a little bit more like Westbrook, or like, oh, I'm in the Hardens, let me go side to side. It's just kind of funny to think like that, even though we're not even close to anybody's level.
So please let us know in the comment section below what your favorite sneaker that we showcased today was, what's your favorite sneaker line moving forward, and why.
And also let us know if there's other sneakers that you really want us to review. We do want to do some more sneaker review videos. Obviously, we don't do them that often, but you know, when we do them, we give you everything we got.
All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching that video. That was our performance sneaker review for the 2019-2020 NBA season.
Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, check out our sponsor, Dashlane, at the link down below. Remember, you can get 10% off Dashlane Premium, or you can get a 30-day free trial off Dashlane.
Till next time, we're the Fun Bros. We out.
Peace.
Foot. I have a wide foot all the way through. Wide forefoot, wide midfoot, big ankle. I don't have any cankles though, like some other.
Not cankles.
No cankles,
David,
bro.
David, strong ankles, not cankles.
No. There's a difference.
Strankles. You guys, strankles. Strunkles.